Of mine, and shall shew it unto you. All things that the Father hath are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine, and shall show it unto you. A little while, and he shall see
so,
me no more.
So you can go to John chapter number 14, verse number 16 to 18.
Verse 16. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but he know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless.
Okay, that's right. So now we can pray for the wait. Let's bow our heads and pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, hear our people of God in the name of Jesus. May you guide them to the word of God in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, may you use me as your vessel of God, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus. May the Spirit of God speak through me, O God, in the name of Jesus. I appreciate you, Lord, and I thank you, Lord. May you give them understanding, O Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Are you excited to be in this place?
Amen.
Are you excited to be in this place? I entitled my message, Personal Relationship with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We live in the times where Christians don't know why Christ came. Hallelujah. Christ came to restore the relationship between man and God. Hallelujah. One of the reasons why Christ came is to restore the relationship between man and God. Hallelujah. So now, people, I mean, especially believers, they don't understand why Christ came. One of the reasons why Christ came. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No, people don't understand why Christ came. Hallelujah. One of the things that Adam messed up on is breaking the relationship of man and God. Hallelujah. Adam sinned. The Bible says that in the book of Romans chapter number 5, verse number 12, the Bible says that Adam sinned and sin entered the world. And then through the sin, the death, I mean, spread upon all men. When I'm speaking about death, I'm not speaking about death of physical only. Hallelujah. I'm speaking about separation between men and God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I'm speaking about the separation between men and God. Now, that's what the Bible says, that Christ is the only mediator between men and God.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that we can have that relationship with God. Now, when you don't have a relationship with God, it is difficult as a Christian. It's difficult to pray. As a Christian, you struggle to pray for 2 minutes. 2 minutes is too much for you, because you lack the relationship with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You cannot read the word of God for 80 minutes. 80 minutes is too much for you. Why? Because you lack the relationship with the Holy Spirit. You can do all things, but then you cannot do the things of God. You can serve God. You can come to church and be an usher for the whole day. But the way you are supposed to read the word of God, it is a different story. Because the word of God, you cannot read the word of God without the relationship with the Holy Spirit. You won't understand the word of God. The word of God won't be interesting to you.
That's true. Yeah.
Hallelujah. This is the crisis that we have in the body of Christ. Hallelujah. This is the crisis that we have in the body of Christ, where Christians, they no longer have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. So now, I spoke about why Christ came. I spoke about why I'm speaking about the relationship between man and God, personal relationship between the Holy Spirit and man. Between man and the Holy Spirit. It's important for us as believers to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. It may be seen as a simple teaching, but I'm telling you, many people in this place are struggling to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Many believers, they are struggling. There are few believers who are having a relationship with the Holy Spirit. There are few believers who know how to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. Many are struggling when we are worshiping God. They cannot worship God. They cannot worship God for 10 minutes, for 5 minutes. Let me drink water. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So now, It's a necessity for us to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. It's a must for us to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. One of the things that I've learned, and I've been speaking about it, one of the things that I've learned, I've been serving God for maybe 4 years or 3 years. But then what I've learned is that God values relationship more than serving Him. God values, many people who are serving God, they've lost their relationship with the Holy Spirit. Many people who are serving God, preachers have lost their relationship with the Holy Spirit. But I'm not talking about preachers. I'm speaking about believers in God, in general. Hallelujah. I'm speaking about believers in general. They are struggling to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. So now God has requested something in my spirit to say, teach my people about the relationship with the Holy Spirit. Because the relationship with the Holy Spirit is the foundation for all the relationship that we want to have. How you relate to your mother? It's because of the foundation. You are lacking the foundation. Hallelujah. How we relate to our classmates, how we relate to other people that are close to us, it depends on the relationship with the Holy Spirit. Now I want to teach how to the importance of having a relationship with the Holy Spirit. I believe that you will see will help me, because the main thing that I want to do to teach is about how to develop a relationship with the Holy Spirit. But then I cannot teach about how to develop a relationship with the Holy Spirit without teaching about what is the importance of the Holy Spirit in a believer. Now, the importance of the Holy Spirit, number one, the importance of the Holy Spirit is to empower believers on daily basis. Hallelujah. Yes. Is to empower believers on daily basis. Because believers, they face challenges on daily basis. Hallelujah. Every day, believers, they face challenges. Now, the Holy Spirit is there to assist believers. The Holy Spirit is there to speak through the believers. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit, now, the Bible says that in the book of Romans chapter number 8, verse number 2, it says that the power of the Spirit of God have given you ability to overcome sin. Hallelujah. Have given you ability to overcome sin. Now, one of the things that we learn about the Holy Spirit is that the Holy Spirit, it gives you power to empower sin each and every day. Hallelujah. You cannot struggle with fornication when you are having a relationship with the Holy Spirit. You cannot struggle in homosexuality when you are having the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, the power of the Holy Spirit has been bestowed on believers, that believers cannot be on the same position. Hallelujah. But believers cannot be on the same position. You are in this side. You are not born again. Hallelujah. You are struggling with fornication. You come this side, you receive the Holy Spirit. You still struggle with the good fornication. It's impossible. There's no difference between you and an unbeliever. There must be a difference. Now, you are not, God doesn't expect you to do it alone. I like the slogan of Liverpool, even I'm not a fan of Liverpool, say, you shall not walk alone. I'm not a fan of Liverpool, I'm a city fan. Hallelujah. I'm a city fan. I'm not a fan of Liverpool. I like their slogan. Because they say, you shall not walk alone. Even when they are wedding their guests, they are talks, hallelujah. I'm going to leave this thing, but then I never managed to leave them until I found a secret of saying that a man has to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Now, since Christ came that may have a relationship with the Holy Spirit, it's an insult to the cross when we still live in sin.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because Christ, according to Christ, Christ has given us, I mean, enough tools to defeat sin,
Amen.
Which is the Holy Spirit. When I'm speaking about the Holy Spirit, I'm not speaking about the spirit of man. I'm speaking about the spirit of God.
Amen.
The spirit of God cannot live in sin. The spirit of God cannot accommodate sin.
Amen.
It seems like I'm rebuking people, but then I'm not rebuking people. But what I'm telling people is to say, you have been given power to defeat sin.
Amen.
Hatred is not your portion. Unforgiveness is not your portion. Jealousy is not your portion. Fornication is not your portion. Homosexuality is not your portion. Hallelujah. Now we have to tell people that poverty is not your portion. But we forget to tell people that sin is not your portion. Sin is not where you are supposed to be. You are supposed to be an example to the world. Of the kingdom of God. First Corinthians chapter 2 verse 10. We cannot read it, but that's why I said I want to focus on how to develop the relationship with the Holy Spirit out of time. In order for you to understand how the kingdom operates, in order for you, when you come to this kingdom, there are new rules. It's not like in the world where you just wake up. You need to communicate with God.
Amen.
You don't just wake up. You have a father now. You are no longer an orphan.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Mm. You have a father. You cannot just wake up. You just have to say, good morning, Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And the Bible says one of the work of the Holy Spirit, the importance of the Holy Spirit is to show us the things that are going to come. In the Old Testament, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of God was upon prophets, kings, and high priest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, the Spirit of God now is no longer upon